Happy Monday, Northern Lion. People can't see anything on my screen yet because it's capturing the wrong image. So it's forgive me, but yes, happy Monday. I know that we have concluded that we are indeed on the correct map.
It's true. And hey, man, it's February.
It is February.
Not yet. I mean, for us, it'll be February tomorrow. I don't want to spoil it, but you know.
I feel like we can get away with like... I think the audience pretty much like knows now that like they get it.
Yeah, it's not recorded the second before it goes.
Yeah,
out.
Yeah. I mean, like it's fun to like to play like it is, but come on now. I think that we've it's 2020. We can lift the veil on the GeoGuessr recording process, and you know, I think we're all stronger because of it.
Well, speaking of which, 3, 2, 1, good luck.
Good luck. Have fun.
Can I tell you? So I got to move this big sack of almonds out of the way. Because it's blocking my map.
I've got a lot of follow-up questions after you're done.
Dude, I bought 750 grams of almonds. That's like a pound and a half. And there is nothing worse. I bit into the first almond, and it was like soft.
Oh, God.
They screwed me. I bought almonds in bulk without sampling. And then they're all like the soft almonds that have no crispness to them whatsoever.
Yeah, those are the worst because then it's like you're eating like a crayon.
Yeah, and they get stuck in your teeth like crazy and.
Yeah, no, thank you. Are you gonna bring them back? That's the real question. Are you gonna bring them back and ask for?
Oh, no, absolutely not.
Was that too boomer for you or what?
I would never. Absolutely, I will say without hesitation that is too boomer for me.
Okay.
I would never bring back a food to the grocery store.
I'm actually with you on this. This is the only exception to that rule. It would be if it was just egregiously like rotten. Like I have in my lifetime, I've only returned one thing back to the grocery store ever, and it was because I had a grossly out of date package of the deli meat, like the ham.
Yeah,
and it looked fine, but then like this is what led me to always check the dates before I leave the aisle. It was actually out of date by like 4 months.
Oh, 4 months.
4 months. I don't know how.
That's crazy.
I don't know how that. I don't know what's going on in my camera. I'm being teleported mid teleport right now. Everything has like gray and white like teleportation lines. I don't know what's going on. But yeah, so I don't know how that happened, but I took it back and like I was like, hey, I need to return this. I said, all right, let me get the manager, and I showed her. I was like. This is an unopened package of Oscar Mayer ham, and it's 4 months out of date. And she looked at it, she's like, that came from here? I was like, yeah, I have the receipt. I literally just bought it yesterday. They were mortified and horrified.
What do you, where do you just line up as if you're going to buy something, but then give them tell them the story when you get up there?
Well, there's a customer, in our grocery store, there's a customer service desk. That like you go up to if it's super busy and the cashiers like can't get to you.
Okay.
They've got like a little line. It's the same line where like there's like the in-store bank and stuff.
Okay. I mean that's like
and their manager is there, yeah.
I understand that, I guess. We have not an in-store bank, but we have like a lottery ticket kiosk that I think maybe serves the same protocol.
Okay.
As far as
yeah,
I know.
A kiosk is probably a better way to do it. But they have it's like it's integrated. It's also the place where you can get like your car inspection paid and all that kind of stuff. You guys don't have that up there?
So I'm not gonna say that we don't.
Okay.
But in Vancouver is definitely it would be a rarity, I would say.
Okay.
Outside of the city, like in my hometown, yeah, there's grocery stores where you can you know, they have like a 24-hour pharmacy and you know, 1-hour photo place and the maybe like especially you know what's weird, Asian grocery stores very frequently have like a travel agency inside of them here.
Really?
It's like it's a you know I guess if you speak Korean but don't speak English, you're like, hey, this is like the cultural center of like my shopping life, so you can get everything there.
It's like an all-purpose desk.
It's got everything. Lawyer, real estate, insurance, travel, et cetera, et cetera.
I think that means this. Okay, thank God. Wow, you beat me by 56.
I found a gas station.
That's crazy. I was in UAE until like I took a second look at the flag and saw the white dot in the middle, and I was like, I'm getting bamboozled again, Jordan. You're not doing this to me. Shout out to Jordan though for having
English science.
Well, not only that, but like national pride. There's flags everywhere.
Yeah, very true. Now, if only I could figure out which one of the green, black, and red flags is which country without having to see a sign that has the nation's capital on it. It would be a dream come true.
Yeah,
I've seen those big grocery stores, but mostly, to be honest, is when we like go down to our in-laws' place near Seattle, and then we'll stop by like a Fred Meyer or something like that. And I am just in awe at the size of the store. Always.
Fred Meyer?
Fred, you don't have Fred Meyer in Texas, maybe? I don't know.
We do not. If we do, it is unbeknownst to me.
I'm trying to think of the other. I don't know. Every region's got its own grocery stores. Fred Meyer might be a Northwest sort of thing. It's just a Walmart, basically.
Yeah, it's a Canadian Walmart.
Well, Seattle, Washington Walmart.
Is it? Are you seeing this language over here?
I saw a language.
Was it on the side of a building?
It was on a gate preceding a building.
It was on a gate.
It was on a gate.
Oh, look at the puppy.
But the language did not surprise me. That's what I'll say about that.
Really?
Yes.
Because I'll level with you. At the first like inclination was that we got to be somewhere in far eastern Europe.
Okay.
Just,
yeah.
That was just from like I think I'm actually going backwards. That was from just like seeing just the surroundings and looking at a clothesline and a couple of buildings that were, let's just say they looked used. Quite a lot.
Oh, yes. A used building. I was thinking about that because, you know, we moved out of our the apartment we used to rent, obviously, like 3 months ago.
Right.
Sometimes in my travels, I still find myself going by the building. And I think to myself, like, it's occupied by somebody else, but I had it first. It's like you're getting my sloppy sec on tenancy. I don't take pride in it necessarily, but I think like choose if I had to choose between living in it, you know, first or living in it second, I definitely would choose to live in it first.
I am looking forward to the housing process this year.
Mm.
I don't know why
it can
people
be fine.
I don't know why people are. I mean, okay, I understand why they would tell me this. Like, oh, it's a nightmare. It's a pain. It's like, you know, it's just not fun or whatever. But like, I've had the preliminary stuff that I did for looking for houses and stuff, and like, I'm excited about planning out like what kind of house I want is like fun.
I think that is a fun part. I will agree with you. I'm just picking a guess. I'm not guessing yet, but I'm just gotta put something down. I haven't seen anything yet.
Dude, though. I don't freaking know.
For me, there were two big drags. One drag was moving, which just always kind of sucks.
Yeah, yeah.
But to be honest, we probably own. I mean, we were moving from like a 600 square foot apartment. We probably own more than the average person who had a 600 square foot apartment did. It was a surprising move for the relative smallness of where we used to live.
Is that before or after you got rid of the Northern Lion mailbox?
Yeah. Well, we still have that, but
wow, I was way off. You got relatively way off. You got me by 1943. Okay.
You were in
like
Argentina,
that.
Maybe?
I was on the corner of Chile, Argentina, and Bolivia, but towards the bottom there because I was trying to border Chile. I had no idea where we were.
Oh, me neither, basically. I was just like, if I had to pick, is this north or south? And I was like, I don't know. Feels north, I guess.
Yeah. I guess I should have taken cues from all the jungle and stuff. But it's so hard. Like,
Oh, I mean, there was just Spanish.
Yeah, just saying Spanish,
foliage.
And that's it. Yeah.
And then, so the other drag was just like, and maybe other people have different tolerances for this, but the amount of people who get a slice, like when you purchase a property,
yes,
I was getting bled dry by professions that I didn't even know existed on it.
Yeah,
you go to the bank and the bank is whatever. Then, you know, you get all that paperwork sorted out. Then you've got to go to a notary. And I didn't know that. I mean, I know what a notary is, but I did not prior to this really understand what they did. I guess they're kind of a basically like a real human being CAPTCHA. If you know what I mean.
No, I got you on that.
Like their whole job is just to identify that you are who you say you are and, you know, like look at documents and then sign a series of pages. And then the notary got paid. And I was like, man, you didn't do anything. Like, no disrespect. I respect the hustle. But literally, like, you're so lucky that your job is required by the government because you did zero.
Absolutely
in this
nothing.
Well, OK, they did the paperwork to, like, you know, transfer the title or something like that, which is fair enough. But
well, I found out, I don't remember if we mentioned that on the GeoGuessers series, but I found out that the underwriter exists.
Oh, the insurance underwriter.
In Texas, the underwriter for me is more tied to the lender.
Oh, okay. So, I mean, they're basically assessing your risk of,
yeah,
risk factor on the mortgage. Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. 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 I think we're over here.
You know where we're not? England as of 12 hours ago. I saw the EU flag. Hindsight shouldn't have told you that. It might have given you some information.
No, I think I'm in more of a better spot. I'm not sure if I have the actual country, but I think I'm in a more accurate spot of the continent. That's a big horse. Have you seen this horse carrying like a couple on like a hollowed out canoe with four wheels?
Don't try to distract me.
I'm just saying.
I'm trying to figure out. It's the classic font where I'm like, what country are you? I don't know.
The font.
You know what I mean.
But no, I found out that the underwriter has more power than anyone else in the whole process. I was originally going to look for a house last year, and I was told that I need to maintain a certain level of income for an entire year before I'm allowed I mean, you can apply for a loan whenever, but before, like, they're like, you could get a much better rate if you just work for another year and just save up money.
Oh, that's good.
I was like, all right, so I'm going to work hard for another year to make the whole housing process easier on myself for the rest of my life, sort of thing.
Is this,
you know?
This was from the bank?
No, this is from the lender.
Oh, okay. Because I was going to, like, that sounds foreign to me, but I think that it's because a bank just has, like, a set rate.
Yeah, I never applied for the loan because I had to, oh, that is a flag. Oh God, 5 seconds left. I don't know. I probably should have gone over there. You got me by a little bit, 127.
It was just, honestly, staggering luck on my part.
I saw a flag within 5 seconds, and I couldn't move fast enough to go see around it. But I was already on the border of Lithuania and Latvia, and I knew it wasn't Belarus because there wasn't any Russian. But the line, it's like you see those straight lines over the characters like that.
Yeah,
and it throws you for a loop because there's like three different countries that do that, and they're all next to each other.
I'll tell you, 100% of the time, I always put us in Hungary and Bulgaria,
mm-hmm.
and then work it back from that point onwards.
you said you got lucky. What'd you see?
I saw the text only.
Okay.
And then went, every time I think this is Hungary, it's always actually one of these countries. Latvia. And then I just kind of stuck us in Latvia, Lithuania.
Gotcha.
But I guess, like, you know, it's less of a guess and more of knowledge. Now that I think about it, it's like,
it's not geo knowledge, Northern Lion. Well, geo guess.
I was like, I don't know it, but I guess if you search your brain and then, you know, you're like, hey, the evidence that I have supports this claim, then that is what knowing is, isn't it?
I'm not messing with you, but this corner house looks like a house that you would build in The Sims 4 and you didn't know how the roofing tool worked.
Because
there's triangles everywhere.
You know what it looks like? It looks like a house where you would not want to have a flat roof because snow would accumulate on it and collapse.
No, I understand the architectural integrity and structure of the design, except this design takes that to an extreme, brother. I'm talking, there's corners everywhere.
So do you know what country we're in here?
I do not yet.
Okay.
I see red buildings.
So you're drawing an inference.
Yeah.
I understand. No matter which of these countries it is, I don't believe I've ever seen like this kind of suburb neighborhood in them before.
You're betting it's probably Finland.
I could be betting on any number of situations.
Because all the names that I've seen, they want me to believe that it's either Norway or Sweden.
Mm.
I guess it could technically be one of the three.
I also can't get out. I don't know about
yeah,
you.
I've been driving around in circles for like the last minute and a half.
I bet we are like around.
Dude, I'm stuck. Go over here.
I bet we're around here. That's my dang guess right there. Yo, that's a sick car. I cannot conceivably give you directions, but hold on. Let me see if I can get back to it. Look at that. It's like a 1950s. I have no idea what car that is.
But the thing is, the red buildings, though, it's bothering me because red buildings always signify Sweden.
I offer no information nor misinformation.
Well, I mean, you've got like a 3,000 point lead right now.
I probably is, but who knows what number 5 is going to be, you know?
That's true.
All I'm going to say, I'm not going to steer you right or wrong out of respect.
But we know that we're in Scandinavia.
On the advisement of my attorney, I plead the Fifth Amendment.
Freaking guy. Doesn't think they were in Scandinavia.
Under the advisement of my attorney, I've been compelled to plead the Fifth Amendment.
You know what? I'm going to say over here then. Thank God I moved, but you still got me by you still got me by 2,000. I was dialed into Finland the entire time until you answered the way that was. I was like, you know what?
I mean, how could I have answered it that way?
You know what? This guy, because whenever we're in Scandinavia, we're always honest with each other.
I've never adhered to that rule.
Wow, you got almost 5,000. I guess it was just that was Reykjavik?
I mean, it was just outside of Reykjavik. Because, like, I was looking, I saw a car that said, like, Reykjavik. And I was like, probably not too many businesses off the island that are like the Reykjavik cafe or something. So then I started looking around and I saw population density, but no buildings over like two stories. And I was like, we gotta be close to the capital then.
Oh, I thought I'm sitting here trying to like zoom in on this white sign. And it keeps dodging my camera and only turn out. It's like, oh, this is the church.
Well, what's your score?
15,333.
Oh, you're not behind by that much. You're only behind by 2,300 now.
But it's, well, yeah. I mean, it's not out of reach.
I'm glad I didn't give up any information necessarily on the Iceland guess.
What? in the world am I looking at here?
Yeah, I'm not getting too much yet.
Seen something that sort of threw me off. Because I was expecting somewhere over here.
But it's not South America.
I'm not pointing to South America.
It's not North America, I'll tell you that much.
Well, I don't know. With today's political climate, some people may feel that way.
I've never been to Mexico, okay? Or Central America, which I guess is North America. This doesn't look like any part of Canada or the U.S. I've ever seen.
What's this guy? You know what? I don't even want to know what that guy's doing. This is an odd one.
Yes, I would be intending to agree with you on that one.
Very odd one. As in, we may have never been to this country, and if we have, this is a part that we've never seen before.
That seems appropriate. I wouldn't disagree with you. I'm relying on my 90-day fiancé skills now.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
I'm like, does this look like where Michael lives?
Just why don't you use your same logic that you guys played, what, Clue the other day on the NLSS? He looks like...
Oh, you when we played Guess Who.
Oh, Guess Who, that's what it was, yeah.
That's South America. I zoomed in on the wrong continent.
I'm gonna go out on a limb.
Kind of think we're like there, but
man. You know where we are?
No, I do not. So I'm taking like a coward's guess.
I got 30 seconds left. What do you mean a coward's guess?
What do you mean?
What do you mean by that?
Well,
where could you have guessed?
What guess would a non-coward make?
Man, I'm probably way off on this. Are we over there? We were almost next to each other.
Oh, really?
That was South Africa?
Yeah, I'm surprised as well. I thought we what sent me to Nigeria was I saw what to me seemed like a lot of religious iconography. And
yeah,
I was
that's
I remember when that one time we were in Nigeria, every road was like Jesus Road, Christ Alley, like but yeah, it's Lesotho.
Well, I mean when we were in what was it? Not Benin. We were somewhere up there where there was like a lot of religious stuff. It may have been Senegal, one of those guesses. But at the very beginning, I saw Chinese, or it was Chinese,
really?
Or Japanese. I was like, what? But it was on a van.
Mm.
And I guess technically that wasn't is Lesotho, is that considered part of South Africa? Like the country itself, or is it just?
No, I think it's its own sovereign nation.
Because that would explain why we didn't see the usual South African road signs.
True. Yeah. Very true.
Wow. Well, yeah. I think that's the first for us to ever get that country. Good run. It was
you
a
as well.
Mediocre showing.
I mean, honestly, it was pretty much just Ecuador and Iceland that got me there today.
Yeah, because the Jordanian guess was pretty much even. Let me look at the full results here. Where did you make the biggest leap that you had?
Probably
the second guess.
Oh, and the Iceland one. I thought you said I got you by 2,000. And I was like, I don't even think that's possible.
No.
Unless you picked like the Atlantic Ocean or something.
No, it was 2,000 on the South American guess.
Okay.
Yeah, it was
that explains it.
It was 1,900 on the second guess, and then you got chip points all the way up.
Yeah.
But hey, today was a tough round.
It was. We wish you the best of luck if you played along with us. Of course, if you enjoyed the episode, click the like button. Helps out a great deal. Subscribe if you'd like to see more in the future. These come out every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. We'll see you on Wednesday.
See you later.